Welcome to the Eli Area Public Library in Lake Zurich, Illinois. This video presentation is being premiered on September the 15th, 2021, and it will remain available for viewing on the library's YouTube page for at least a year. Please continue to use it and share it with your teachers and your friends. It's a good reference material for the many styles of folk music that exist throughout Mexico. This video was created to reach audiences during the pandemic. And while we are not quite out of the woods yet, we have started performing live concerts again. So if you're interested in catching a live show, look us up at sonesdemexico.com/events. But for now, let's begin our music journey through Mexico.
Welcome to Beyond the Music, a musical geography of Mexico. My name is Juan Diaz, and I'm one of the co-founders of the group Sones de México Ensemble. This is a nonprofit organization that we founded in 1994 to promote a greater appreciation of Mexico's traditional and regional music and culture. This presentation, with the aid of this map, six talented multi-instrumentalist musicians, and a collection of over 50 musical instruments will take us through a musical journey through various regional styles of music from Mexico, each with its own ethnic and historical characteristics. We have also added a few additional colors like drums and bass to give it, let's say, that Chicago plugged-in sound. But in general, I will be providing you with a brief introduction before each song, giving you a little context for each style so that we may better appreciate the nuances and the uniqueness of each style. This program was developed with partial funding from the National Endowment for the Arts, also the Illinois Arts Council Agency, the Chicago Department of Cultural Affairs and Special Events, the MacArthur Fund for Arts and Culture at the Richard A. Driehaus Foundation, the Gaylord and Dorothy Donnelly Foundation, the Chicago Community Trust, and the generosity of individual donors like you who help us make these programs possible. Normally, we take these presentations on the road around the country and we present them in schools, universities, public libraries, and cultural centers. But given the current constraints on live music performance, we decided to go into a movie studio and film this presentation so that we could bring it to you. So we hope you enjoy it. Let's begin. We begin our journey in the center of Mexico, right about here. In the Huasteca region, was once dominated by the Aztecs, and the language spoken by the Aztec was the Nahuatl language, which was imposed into this region as well. So to this day, many people in the Huasteca region still speak the Nahuatl language. The next thing we're going to hear is spoken in this language. It's called Xochipitzahuac, which means frail little flower. Enjoy.
Guadalupe. María Guadalupe, y acá compañero, ti vaya lo ti María, de Maigualoche en Patonán, Santa María Guadalupe.
The Huasteca region is a tropical rainforest, and the style of music we can hear from here is called son huasteco. Son, spelled S-O-N, is a word that comes from the Latin word for sound, sonus. The name of Sones de México Ensemble comes from this word. Sones means various styles of son from different parts of Mexico. So son by itself doesn't mean anything all on its own. We always have to pair it up with a regional marker, like the Huasteca. So son huasteco is the sound of the Huasteca region. So we're going to listen to a song now performed on an instrument just like this one. This is called guitarra quinta huapanguera. And it's an instrument, it's a baritone guitar that was used for this style of music. We also have this little companion guitar called the jarana huasteca, and together they provide the rhythmic backbone for this style of music. We're also going to hear in the singing voice a falsetto that breaks like a yodel at one point, and this is very characteristic of this style. The lead instrument in this song is going to be the fiddle, and it's very it's a solo fiddle, very ornamented. The name of the song we're going to hear is called La Petenera, and this is a song that talks about maritime themes, about creatures that you may find in the ocean, in spirits. Enjoy.
Thank you.
That was wonderful music, wasn't it? Well, we're going to stay in the Huasteca region a little longer, and we're going to take you up into a variant of this style that exists up in the mountains. As we climb up in the mountains here in the Huasteca region, we get to the Sierra Gorda, and there's a style we call arribeño, the upper Huasteca style. In this style, there is almost the same instrumentation. We begin to see a different guitar used here that is seen in mariachi groups. This is called a vihuela. One of the things we find is the use of poetry in recitation. And we're gonna do a little bit of that in this piece.
Las dunas, de qué miel harán los quesos. Ay, qué ingratas son algunas que no saben dar ni besos.
amazing how many styles of music we can find in Mexico. And let's continue our journey and let's take you to a region that sounds completely different. We're going to go to northern Mexico. This swath of land in the entire northern Mexico, and including some parts of the southwest United States, has a lot of music that originated in Central Europe. We have polkas, waltzes, schottisches, mazurkas. And it's no coincidence because many people from that part of the world arrived into these territories and brought with them the instruments and the musical styles from this area. We're going to listen to a song called La Marieta, which is a polka that was played in the states of Durango and Zacatecas by what was known as the Orquestas Típicas. Enjoy.
Teniendo carne en casa salen a buscar ratones. Esto es lo verdadero, esto es la realidad. Que amamos mil mujeres con toda falsedad.
Marieta, no seas coqueta, porque los hombres son muy malos. Prometen muchos regalos y lo que dan son puros palos.
¡Échale, pues!
Well, we're beginning to see just how diverse styles of music we can find in Mexico. All this music came from Central Europe, brought by immigrants from that part of the world to Mexico, who brought with them instruments such as the button accordion and the upright bass. And this instrument that was created in Mexico called the bajo sexto, which is a 12-string guitar, which has a kind of a deep sound. We're going to listen to a little medley of songs. We're going to start with a schottis, which is a French style rhythm honoring the city of Monterrey. Second, we're listening to a polka called La Cápsula, and we're going to finish with a style that borrows a little bit from the Huasteca region, but with a completely different spin. It's called the Huapango Norteño, and this one is in a minor key, which is makes it even more unique. Enjoy.
escucho tus canciones, Monterrey con tu cerro de la silla y con tus grutas de García. Monterrey, Monterrey de mis amores, yo te voy a cantar esta canción por la gracia que tienen tus mujeres. Ellas saben querer de corazón. En la plaza Zaragoza los domingos se pasean las muchachas más hermosas de mi lindo Monterrey. En la plaza Zaragoza los domingos se pasean las muchachas más hermosas de mi lindo Monterrey. ¡Uya!
That was very good, wasn't it? Well, not all of the music from Northern Mexico came from Europe. There was some indigenous music in Mexico as well. And one of them that we'd like to show you comes from this region of here in the state of Sonora, which comes from the Yoreme people, also known as the Yaqui. They have a dance where they channel the spirit of a deer. It's called a deer dance or La Danza del Venado. We're going to see three of the members of Sones de Mexico performing on a water drum, which is a gourd floating on a pool of water, play upside down like a capsized boat. Then we're hearing a scrape stick like this one. It's just a serrated stick that's going to represent the breathing of the deer as it moves through the. And then I will be playing some rattles that are made from the cocoons of a moth that grows in the desert, and they'll be wrapped around my arms, and we'll be singing our best attempt at the Yoreme language. In this song, as I am told, the dancers do not imitate a deer, but they channel the spirit of the deer. So for a brief moment in this great spiritual rapture, they become the deer themselves. Enjoy. That was quite something, wasn't it? One of the characteristics of indigenous music in Mexico is its great sense of spirituality. Music for indigenous peoples of Mexico wasn't always a form of entertainment or fun and dance. It was a way of cleansing the spirit or connecting with the spiritual world. We are now going to take you to the state of Michoacán. Up in the plains, in the higher area of Michoacán, near the capital of Morelia, there are the territory that was occupied by the Purépecha. The Purépecha are very proud keepers of their culture. They have maintained their language and traditions for many years through the Spanish conquest and modern Mexico as a nation, and they have maintained their status as almost as an independent nation. The Purépecha have a dance or a ritual where young people wearing masks representing old people will do mischief and summon the rain or dance around town, drawing laughter from different people. And we're going to perform this Danza de Viejitos, the dance of the old people. Enjoy. We'll be right back. That was pretty intense, wasn't it? Well, one of the styles of music that most people associate with Mexico is mariachi, right? And it's almost like an icon of Mexican music, but it does have its origins in a regional area of Mexico. And let's look at this western part of Mexico. Right here is where mariachi originates, in the states of Jalisco, Michoacán, Colima, and even Nayarit. This is the cradle of mariachi music. During the early times of mariachi, one of the popular things to do was to connect different folk dances together and string them along into a medley, which was called a jarabe. So jarabes are medleys of different folk dances and folk rhythms. We're going to perform for you a very well-known jarabe, representative of Jalisco in its capital city of Guadalajara. This is called Jarabe Tapatío. I'm sure you'll recognize it. Let's go now to the coast of the state of Guerrero. We continue our journey down the coast of the Pacific, now to the next state, Guerrero, and also the state of Oaxaca. We call this the small coast, the Costa Chica of Guerrero. Now, one particular thing about this area is that at one point in the late 1840s, it was populated by people from African descent. In Latin America, slavery ended at the time of independence, which was in the 1820s. By the 1840s, there were skilled miners in South America that heard about the discovery of a great deposit of gold in California. We all know about the gold rush of the 1849, which not only drew people from eastern United States traveling across the United States to populate California, but also brought people from China and South America who were traveling up the coast to California. Now, all that gold was not found, and some of the black immigrants from South America settled in the west coast of Mexico, where they found deposits of silver. To this day, this population has remained in Mexico and now forms one of Mexico's black populations. We're going to take you to the area of Tixla, which is this striped area over here, about 100 kilometers in from the ocean. There's a series of dances where dancers imitate the movements of different animals. And this is very much done in a style that was imported from the areas of Peru and Chile in South America, where they also dance with a handkerchief up in the air, and they use a very peculiar instrument, which is the jawbone of a donkey. This instrument is used by scraping the teeth with a deer antler and also hitting the sides with the fist to make all the teeth vibrate. The name of this song is called La Iguana. I hope you enjoy it.
Y valedor, ahora acabo de llegar. Ahora acabo de llegar, ay sí, valedor. Apenitas ahora empiezo, ay sí. Quiero que me des un beso, ay sí, valedor. Ya con esta me despido, la iguanita se acabó. Ya con esta me despido, la iguanita se acabó. Que se acabe enhorabuena, como no me acabe yo. Que se acabe enhorabuena, como no me acabe yo. Uy, 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 qué iguana tan fea. Miren cómo se menea. Uy, 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 qué iguana tan loca. Miren cómo abre la boca. Se sube al palo, uy, 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 que ya se subió. Uy, 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 que busca su cueva. Uy, 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 que ya la encontró. Uy, 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 que se mete en ella. Uy, 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 que ya se metió.
Well, as we travel east and south on the Pacific, we reach the end of Mexico. The last state in Mexico is the state of Chiapas. And up in this area of Mexico, one of the most iconic instruments in Chiapas is the marimba, this wooden xylophone that has become so iconic of the music of Chiapas. We're going to hear a special arrangement that was recorded by Sones de México a few years ago. It's called Feria Chiapaneca. Enjoy. We'll be right back. The music from the state of Veracruz is called Son Jarocho, the sound of the jarochos. And jarocho is the nickname we give to people and things from the state of Veracruz. Let's take a look. This region of Veracruz, the state of Veracruz, is a long strip of land along the coast of the Gulf of Mexico. And it includes the seaport of Veracruz, the city of Veracruz, also by the same name, which has been one of the main seaports of Mexico with contact with people from all over the world. As any major seaport around the world, like New York, New Orleans, Amsterdam, etc., there are places that are very cosmopolitan and have influences of music from all over the world. So it is to be expected that the music of Veracruz also has Spaniard influences, indigenous influences. And one of the influences that arrived in Veracruz has been black music from Africa. There's an important black presence in Veracruz. So we're going to play a song about a black woman, La Morena, the brown-skinned woman. And one of the instruments we're going to hear in the song is this guitar called the jarana. It has 8 strings and is used as a strumming instrument to support the rhythm of this music. So let's listen to La Morena. Well, what a grand finale, right? This takes us to the end of our music geography of Mexico. We have seen so much variety and diversity. If there is one takeaway from this whole performance, let it be that Mexico is an extremely diverse country. Next time somebody asks you, do you like Mexican music? Perhaps you should answer, which one?